nice, tidy spare storage. It's got a bit out of hand. Oh well. Moment of truth. Will a spare hazard switch resolve my woes with a lack of indicators? Well, that was a bit of a faff. In the end, the relay was loose as well. 21. Anyway, all round. Hooray! What a relief. So I've just backfilled the metal I'm adding in here, the inner frame, with fibre filler. It's partly because I don't trust my welding, but also just because I want to be doubly sure it's going to stay in the aperture. Plus, I'm going to carry on sanding and filling, make a nice edge to this, so it'll probably be fairly thin metal by the time I've finished with it. But I've checked to see whether the door can open. That was part of my worry, was that the hinge on this side would interfere with the ridge, or rather the ridge would interfere with the door being able to open to 90 degrees, but it's all in place, so quite relieved. Nice to come back to this. So how we do Friday night. Cheers, Walt. Cheers, all. Oh, it's just heaven when it works. That fits in so snugly around the calorifier. Need to check the tops and give them a trim. It's a nice, really nice finish, this bradite. I don't know if you can catch it in the light, but yeah, there we go. So it's slightly shiny, semi-gloss, but still subtle. And the important thing is, it's for me, is that the paint's light, because that at least gives the illusion of space. Even if there isn't any. Why do I do that? I spoke too soon and now look. This sits proud. It sits higher because of the chlorifier. And now doesn't quite go down. So I either need to pack out, as I've already done with another bit of ply underneath there, and raise it the whole length, which means it might be slightly high here. Actually, that's not too bad there. Probably raise that side. Oh well, yeah, it'll do. It'll be away. Just cutting the waterproof top layer of shower floor from the PVC cladding, and I've remembered that I needed to use the shower walls as templates before I put them into the van, so that's quite a relief. Just going to draw around the outside of this one. Okay, this could be the last time I put the shower floor down. And of course, having said that, it now won't be. There we go. So that's PVC cladding going down on top of waterproofed ply, and hopefully that will now screw down directly flush with that hole once it's all sealed. Little bit of deburring and some sealant and we're done.
It's
the first Saturday in 2 weeks I've been out, so I've had a full day of it. I camped out the side in the Florida last night, so you get an early start. I'm pretty knackered now. This is probably my biggest achievement, though. That's the toilet cassette removal hatch, freshly painted. You can see a bit of filler, damn it, but that's fine. By my standards, I'm happy with that bit of innovation. What else have we been doing? Oh, the steering wheel dashboard are back in, finally. I've got functioning hazard lights. Woohoo! Still need to fix the fog light. I'm kind of avoiding doing the electrics. It's not one of my favourite things. I'm building the... this is a console to go above the cab, where the CD radio, Bluetooth, whatever thing will go there, so it's easily reachable from the back. I've spent quite a lot of work on furniture. This is the blue paint is tanking membrane. Actually, I could put a second coat on that before I go home. This is the right hand side panel of the shower as you step into it. And these cubbies are going to be cupboards for cosmetics, toothbrushes, whatever other toiletry stuff that you put in out of the way. And I think they're going to have a push button on this side and open out that way, which is why I've kept that hard edge. This is behind the fridge. The rest of that will be fridge. And then that one's behind the grill. The rest of that will be grill with a little bit of storage right at the top. So the tanking needs to be completed, and then the cladding, PVC cladding, which I've got to figure out how to cut out, will be stuck onto that with a sanitary sealant. This is the toilet drawer and the lip for the toilet drawer, so that's going to be mounted under there. And this will slide, the bottom of this will slide along the shower floor, so it had to be totally sealed. And it's nice and dry, actually, but I'm too exhausted to do any more today. The timbre door. Just trying to fit the timbre door into the shower, that aperture in the shower wall. It looks really good. I think it's going to work. It's going to be very tight. I've got the wrong type of spool to coil it up with. I'm not going to use the coil. I'm just going to use a right angle length, so I need to order that. I don't have space for this, such a bulky thing, so I need a more elegant solution. So I'm just going to get a right angle piece of this, which will fold away. So these mount in the side here, so I had to widen my cut to fit them. And then the timbre door goes across there, and we'll shut it up and come back in over the loo, so you can slide the loo out. Inside, oh yeah. It's like a big jigsaw. Yeah. Reason it's not quite vertical, but you get the idea. So look as I imagined it would. So you step up into the van, then you step up into the cab, and the cab's sort of lounge. Both seats swivel. This side will make a bed. Foot cubby hair there, so your feet can go through into a little box. Looks quite tall, actually. Have I cut that right? Anyway. And the box for the feet will be above the above the toilet, and the toilet's on rails and slides out into the shower. This was my, I might have filmed it already, I can't remember, but this has come out really nicely. It's might need another little bit of sealant around there, just so it's absolutely flush, but I was quite pleased how I managed to adapt my design. Probably need a squeegee still to squeegee the water out, don't you, in all campervan showers, we're probably, so that's all ready to be plumbed in. So it's going to be another 2 weeks till I'm back out here. A bit disappointing, but I'm going to earn some money to pay for some of it, I suppose. But it feels like taking quite a leap forward today. And I think the key thing is having a good list. So the advantages about being off for 2 weeks is that you inevitably build quite a long list of things to do, and as long as you can tick them off as you go, then satisfying work. So, yeah. Right, see you next time.